Hello, in this video we're going to take a close-up look at the Fotomate range of tripods. There's a few models in the range to choose from. We've homed in on the models that we think have got the most relevance for our area of interest, which regular viewers know is not specifically photographic, but more to do with the use of optical aids, so binoculars, spotting scopes, and telescopes. So we're not going to concentrate too much on the more basic models that have got quite a bit of photographic feature, but we're going to concentrate more on one or two of the top models. Anyway, let's kick off with a couple of the basic models, because although they're basic, they've actually got some really quite nice features that I think lift them above some of the other tripods we've seen in this price range. The models that we're looking at here, these two, this is the 5006 and this is the 6006. Superficially they look quite similar. Slightly different maximum heights with both of these. We've got just under 1.6 meters with the 5006 and around about 1.7, so quite a bit higher than this in fact, around about 1.7 meters for the 6006. When you get close to them, you can see straight away that one of the differences is in leg thickness. So on the 5006 we've got a leg thickness of 26 millimeters and a slightly different profile on the 6006 with 27 millimeter legs, and it does make a difference and it actually increases the carry weight of the tripod. The 6006 got a payload weight of around about 5 kilos and an all-in weight to carry it around of around about 1.9 kilos. So the extra metalwork on the 6006 allows for payloads of up to 6 kilos and increases the carrying weight to around about 2.2. Now, both of these are equipped with two-way heads. They're both the same in that they have an adjustable pan handle, so we can actually undo the wing nut at the front here and rotate the pan handle to anywhere that's comfortable. Now that's a nice feature when you're using binoculars. So if you've got a binocular bracket on here, tripods with straight pan handles can end up hitting you in the throat and it can get pretty uncomfortable. This ability to be able to rotate the pan handle well away from the main axis of the tripod can make the tripod and the instrument obviously a lot more comfortable to use. You can see I can now get the panhandle well clear and the binocular can be in this position without the panhandle interfering me. So that's a nice feature, I like that. One of the other differences between the 5000 and the 6000 is the platform size. They look similar superficially, but when you look at them in a bit more detail, the platform on the 6006 has got a significantly larger surface area. Incidentally, for most of the models that we're showing in the video, you can actually buy spare platforms, and I always regard that as that's a nice thing to be able to do if you've got multiple pieces of equipment. These are fairly inexpensive. You can get extra platforms, stick it on your cameras or your other equipment so that you can move it quickly to the tripod and make use of it rather than having to disentangle the platform from one piece of equipment and put it onto another. Both the 5000 and the 6000 series have both got these long spirit levels rather than simple button spirit levels, which actually makes it quite nice to use. The smoothness of both of the heads, they're quite good. I would put it slightly underneath the kind of standard that you would require for really good video work. So there's no specific video damping performance in the bearings on these, but the bearing surfaces are quite large and they are quite smooth. One little feature is we've actually got divisions on here which would assist panoramic handling of your camera if you were doing panoramic stills or something like that. The leg sections have got a lockable center stay, which I think is quite a nice feature. We can actually lock up the center stay. That's the same on both of these. And one very nice feature is that although we've got a physical screw lock, and incidentally the screw lock on both of these uses an M8 threaded stud. Most tripods you encounter like this, that's probably going to be no bigger than M6. This one is significantly larger, and that's one of the features I like about these tripods. Everything's just that little bit beefier. These platforms we were looking at, for example, I forgot to mention this, they really are very solid. They don't feel like a simple cheap plastic casting. They are made of some kind of fiber reinforced resin, I think. They're actually very, very tough. They seem to be made of a slightly different material to some of the other ABS high pressure castings that are on here. Extensive use of ABS, of course, is what's keeping some of the weight down. Anyway, back to that center column lock again. So we've got a straightforward lock here and a gear riser, which is a very useful feature. Remember, with a gear riser, one of the good things, if you're using it with a binocular, if you're doing group viewing, you can actually lower it down using the gear riser and show a target to someone of reduced stature compared with you, and the target will still be in the center of the field of view. So if you've got the tripod set up nicely, this is a really quite a nice feature when you're doing sort of group viewing, when you're observing with other people. So that's quite a nice feature. Now, merely undoing the lock, or doing the lock up, obviously locks this into position for the duration of your activity, but we've got a rather nice stiction control on the center column here. So by turning the center column, I can increase the stiction whether or not I've got the lock on or not. If I want it to be lighter, I can undo it, just turn it back the other way. In fact, I can turn it so light it actually goes down on its own there. That's a nice feature. It reinforces the sort of competence even on the most basic model, the 5006 here. The center column on the 6006, you can see with the two side by side, it's all significantly beefier, and we've got that self same control here. Other features of note is that although they're using M8 here as well, it's a much beefier knob. Everything is just that little bit bigger and chunkier, and yet this is still a very what I would describe as an economically priced tripod. Okay, let's move on to one of the stars in the Fotomate range. That's the VT2900. This really is a standout, one of the stars in the Fotomate range. It's a very well accomplished tripod. The basic models I was showing you earlier are good value for money, but this tripod, the 2900, is really something quite exceptional. We've got substantial legs here in the region of around about 29 millimeters. They've got, instead of the very simple clip locks on the basic models, the 5000 and the 6000, the 2900 has got these rotary leg locks. Now, we've seen these before on other tripods that we've reviewed. This has been particularly nicely done. Very often, with this type of compression fitting leg lock, when you've done one of the legs up, the lower leg will sometimes rotate. They've countered that by putting a rebate ridge in the back of the leg so that the leg in actual fact is not symmetrical profile, so it won't actually rotate in the compression holding. And as a result, when you handle the tripod, putting the legs up, putting the legs down, everything stays put and there's no fuss and no need to muck around with it at all when you're doing it up. I really like that feature. It's been very, very nicely done. Oops, I need to put it out just a little bit further to level it up. The center column has got the same kind of design that we were looking at on the 5000 and 6000. We've got that stiction control there, which is so useful for when you're carrying heavy loads. We've got the locking center column done with a compression twist this time rather than the simple screw. We've got an overall height here of 1.77 meters, so we're talking about up here somewhere, so it's a great tripod for mounting binoculars for doing astronomy and that kind of thing. Looking at the head, and that's really where this tripod really begins to shine, we've got a complete CNC built aluminium, cast aluminium head here. All metal connections, it's oil filled throughout, so this can easily be used for video. It's got a lovely smooth feel to it. We've got the same feature of the large handle here that rotates in position. It's just been done a bit nicer. It's all metal throughout. We can rotate the handle, plus we've got a teeth retaining system so that we can rotate the handle to any position very precisely and lock it off again. A lot more solid, really does feel good for moving the head around. We've got a very nice spring tension equalizer here as well, which we've got a simple lock on the side, so I've got the lock loose at the moment, and you can see that as I move the as I move the head, if you watch what happens, it recovers its position without any contact from me. Now, that's a great feature for video, certainly, being able to achieve pans with this spring assist, and being able to just encourage the thing in a very smooth flowing movement. But when you're using spotting scopes and that kind of thing, it's also very, very nice to be able to have the balance point on the telescope resisted in this way by this spring tension system. That's got a very nice feel to it. As I said earlier, the head is entirely of aluminium construction, and that includes the quick release plate here, and you can see we've got a very nice security device, a security button at the back here, so I can't actually remove the quick release platform without depressing that. That comes off. We've got fittings on here for 3/8 and quarter Whitworth, so both prosumer and the domestic size can be incorporated. The size of the platform here makes this ideal for small astronomy telescopes. It can be used with larger binoculars. Payload carrying capacity here is a whacking 8 kilograms, so there's a lot of big binoculars and the very biggest spotting scopes that can actually be used with this tripod very easily. This is a very nice build quality on this tripod. Feels good. Price-wise, I think it's exceptional. I'm not going to quote a price. You really need to consult with your local dealer in whatever market you're actually in. Obviously, this has got a certain price in the UK. You may be finding it at a different price elsewhere in Europe. But the price point on this makes this tripod extremely competitive, and it's probably one of the best specified telescope, binocular, spotting scope carrying systems I think we've seen at such a modest price. So that really is a star in the Fotomate range, and that's the 2900. Okay, let's move on to the real stars of the Fotomate range. This is the VT680. You can see straight away that the design differs markedly from the other tripods we were looking at, and the most notable omission is the center column. Now, it's the center column, the rising center column on a tripod, that is one of the biggest causes of shake and shimmy when you've got the center column extended. This tripod does away with the rising center column completely. It still can manage a overall height of 1.97 meters, so that's going to be right up here somewhere. It's going to be almost out of shot. And it achieves the greater part of its stability is actually achieved by this design, where we get this reinforced pyramid structure coming up immediately underneath the tripod head, and it's one of the reasons why this just feels so solid. We've got a two-way pan and tilt on here. All of the components of this structure are all cast aluminium that has then been CNC engineered to give it a very fine fit and finish so that everything fits together nicely. It's a fit and finish, make no mistake, you can feel it when you take any of the components off, like the quick release plate here, and you can see how well that's been engineered. It feels very slick and very precise. Incidentally, we've got a cunning little safety mechanism just here, a little spring-loaded lever. I just push that in to actually put the quick release back into place. When I let go of it, it ensures that this actually can't be moved backwards and forwards. There's no risk of it actually falling out when your equipment was in here. So if something gets cold and shrinks, or you forget to tighten this up properly and you've got a telescope on here or a large binocular, there's no risk that once gravity gets hold of it, that anything is going to fall off the back of the tripod. That's an important feature that no tripod like this used with large optical aids should be without. A nice thing about the handle, we've got that same handle that we saw on the VT 2900, and it's got the ability to rotate to a new position. We can also change the angle of it and turn it all the way upside down like I've done there to get a nice straight pull to it. We can put it at any angle, and it can also be swapped sides, so we can use this as I've got it fitted here for right hand use, or it can be put onto the left hand side. So that's really quite a nice feature. The bearing at all the bearing surfaces, in fact, are oil filled, so we've got a beautiful smooth feel to it. But one of the most important features on the 680 is the spring-loaded tensioner on the altitude axis. Now, what this means is that if I push the panhandle down into quite a steep vertical altitude and let go, you see that the tripod actually recovers itself without any interference from the user at all, and I can just help it along to bring it up level. It won't actually recover typically all the way to the horizontal position once you've got equipment on here, but what it's doing is providing a counteract the effect of the equipment falling backwards suddenly or falling forward suddenly, and giving us this nice firm poised feel to the equipment as we actually move it. We're going to put a big binocular on here in a minute and just get a better idea of what that actually feels like. The locks on here are all fairly obvious. We've got a lock for the altitude, although you could actually see that I was doing all that with the lock off, and it actually feels very solid and positive. Just a little tweak actually locks that up perfectly. For the horizontal lock, I've got another very simple lever here. Again, a fingertip is all that's necessary to lock this tripod head up. Again, that's a function of the CNC engineering. The tolerances are very narrow. All it requires is a little tweak to lock things up. Now, we've got two spirit levels on the head here, which is a nice little feature, and it's telling us that we've got two different methods of actually leveling up. The most obvious one is by changing the length of the tripod legs. Anyone who's done that on any kind of regular basis knows how irritating that can actually be. A little bit on here, a little bit off here, a little bit off there. With this tripod, you only need to get the leg level approximate, because by slackening off this knob underneath, I've got a ball and socket mounting for the head, so it's very easy to get a very precise leveling. I say precise, as precise as you're likely to get with a spirit level with a 1 centimeter baseline, but certainly far more precise than you would get just trying to level the head of the tripod. There you go. And that gives us a, even as I turn that around now, I can see that that's still staying in the center. Now, that's a useful feature all round for all users of optical aids, but it's particularly useful, I think, for doing panoramic photography and that kind of thing, and makes the tripod really very easy to set up. Leg design on this tripod is obviously pretty important. We've got these double aluminium double rails, very well reinforced with their aluminium castings on the end here. We're not going to look at the legs too closely on the 990, because they're almost exactly the same as the design here. They're just a little bit longer, but in principle it's almost exactly the same design. All screw fasteners have been used throughout, so we've got no hidden fasteners that you can't get at. If anything starts to feel a bit loose with long service, you can always just give it a tweak with a hex key and tighten things up. Really love the big knobs here that can be operated with gloves on. There's nothing fiddly about this tripod at all. We've got this big chunky knob here. As I pull the leg up, you can see it's very, very smooth. And incidentally, we've got it at this height, and this is just two leg sections being used. There's another complete leg section to come out yet, and obviously if I put that up, it's going to go out of the frame. This leg design is, again, part of the secret of making this tripod so secure. But let's just test it now by putting a bit of weight on here and getting a sense of what it feels like. Now, the binocular I've put on here is a Helios 100mm large aperture binocular. It weighs in at a little under 7 kilos. The manufacturer's stated carrying capacity for the VT680 is 8 kilograms. When you put this on here, you can actually feel that this is not straining this tripod at all. It really is not breaking into a sweat carrying this binocular. And clearly, I think you could exceed that stated payload range by whatever your risk factor you feel comfortable with, but certainly a couple of kilos easily, maybe significantly more than that, depending on the length and structure of the item. I think if the weight was well puckered over the center of the tripod, I think you could manage significantly more than that. It really does feel good and secure. The spring loading system, you can see, gives me a lot of control. Even though this binocular is very badly out of balance on here and very front heavy, you can feel this is without any kind of lock. I haven't even got it switched in a little bit to add a bit of binding. I've got it completely loose, and you can see that even with the binocular tilting back, hands off, you can see it's creeping back very, very slowly, giving me a really good sense of if I walked away from the binocular and didn't lock it off, there isn't going to be a nasty crunch as something either tips forward or falls backwards. So again, a nice safe tripod to use in a community of people. If you're going to be showing people the night sky, this would be a great tripod to be doing that with. The fact that we can move the handle around here to the most ergonomic position for the users also makes this a great bet for this type of tripod. Can't stress enough just how good this feels. I'm hoping you can actually see that in the video, just how comfortable this binocular is on here. Anyway, let's move on and take a look at the big brother of the 680, the VT990. This is the VT680's big brother. This is the VT990. You can see it's got the same overall design as the 680. We've got this pyramid leg dynamic with the legs coming up immediately underneath the platform. Things to note, we've got exactly the same ball and socket leveling system on here. Got a rather posher spirit level, a bit more precise, a bit easier to see as well in poor lighting, and a much bigger knob underneath here to actually tighten that up. The overall design is approximately the same, it's just everything has been beefed up. This tripod has got a truly astonishing 20 kilogram carrying capacity. Now, when you consider that the actual weight of the device is a whisker under 6 kilos, so it's not much heavier than the 680, and it's an easy tripod for me to just carry around, that really is an amazing ratio, you know, well over or almost four times its own weight as its carrying capacity. That's almost, it makes one a little bit skeptical about just how the tripod's gonna feel when we get something that heavy on here. And we're actually gonna test it in just a minute by putting a real behemoth of a binocular on here and see what that actually feels like. The features on the 680 are pretty much mirrored here across the way. We've got the same pan handle. We can slacken that off and put it to a new position. We can put it to a new overall position as well, with a rather nice engagement system here. It knocks into these teeth. You can see we can put it the other side. It can be positioned on the left-hand side as well. But notice it's just bigger and beefier. The whole head is significantly larger. All the locks on it, they're just that little bit bigger and a bit easier to operate. Given that the carrying capacity is higher, these levers have got to be able to do a little bit more pinching up. One of the ways they've achieved this huge improvement in the carrying capacity is just by getting the engineering tolerances down. We can still just tweak these levers to get it locked up. We've got a locking mechanism for the azimuth index here as well, and again that's just a little tweak just to actually lock that up. The quick release platform, if I tilt that down so that you can see it, that's significantly bigger than the one that we had on the 680, so it's got an even larger footprint surface, so for carrying heavier equipment. We've got to go along with that, we've got a larger security device on it as well, so I need to pull that well clear before actually pulling the plate out. And this is a really nice solid piece of aluminium, and you can actually see how well I think that's been built. And you can probably even hear, I think, not just see, how buttery smooth that is when I put that in there. It really is a nice piece of engineering. The best feature by far for this head, over and above its carrying capacity, is this brilliantly designed tension mechanism. So we've got exactly the same spring tension mechanism that we found on the 680. The difference on the 990 is I can actually disengage it. So I can take the spring balance system out. So now it just performs like a ordinary two-way pan and tilt head. I can just move it up and down and side to side. But at a moment's notice and at any position, so I can advance the engagement by putting the pan and tilt lever relatively high in the air here and pointing the equipment down at the ground slightly. I can then engage the spring balance with this very simple latch, put that into position, and now the balance point is a lot earlier in the mechanism, so that if I've got equipment on here with a very heavy back end, I can move that that poise, that equipoise position, to a new location. You can see it actually lifts it now beyond the horizontal. If I want it back to horizontal, it's the easiest thing in the world to adjust it. Just lift the lever, restore the platform to the level position, re-engage the lever again. Now I've got the spring balance equally positioned on both sides. You would expect underneath these little rubber covers, we've got a number of fastenings. We've got a fastening suitable for video cameras. We've got a prosumer 3.8 and we've got the quarter Whitworth. Incidentally, the VT680 obviously had exactly the same fittings. We had the prosumer 3.8 Whitworth and the normal consumer quarter Whitworth fastening as well. All of the tripods, I think we mentioned that earlier on, all come with cases. The VT680 and the 990 are no exception. They come with very substantial canvas, padded canvas cases that are ideal for carrying the equipment around. I'm going to put a binocular on here and just see how this mechanism works out with it. Let's just do that now. Okay, I told you I was going to put something substantial on here, and I wasn't kidding. This behemoth of a binocular is a Zeiss Kriegsmarine 10x80. It weighs in around about 12 kilos, and this tripod is shrugging it off as though it weighs 2 or 3 kilos. It feels beautifully poised. Normally when you see one of these binoculars, you'll see it mounted on some steel or wooden monstrosity that typically weighs within the range of 1 to 1.5 or even 2 times the weight of the binocular. It's quite common to find it on a tripod weighing around about 15 kilos, maybe even 20 kilos. In this case, we are seeing it here mounted on a tripod that weighs just 5.8 kilos. So 12 kilo payload on a 5.8 kilo tripod, and it feels great. It feels absolutely solid, it feels poised. One of the things that's making this product feel so good, don't forget, this is a full 2 meter height tripod, and if I was gonna be using this outside in the on the night sky, I would have it at least another 10 to 14 inches higher than this. The reason I'm not jacking it up any further is simply because it's gonna be very hard to keep it in shot with me in the shot and then and the binocular, so I'm showing it to you a little bit like reduced height. The thing that really comes into play with when you've got an optical product like this on here is this balance system, this adjustable system that the VT990 has actually got on its head. And what it's allowing me to do is, if I'm going to be using the binocular right up here, I can select the position for this by basically putting the binocular down slightly, engaging the spring balance tension system, and you can see that when the binocular is poised for a position at high altitude in the sky, it just makes the, you can see this actually wants to go back slightly, which is a preposterous situation when you consider just how out of balance this actually is, and yet it's being held in this beautifully poised position by that spring tensioner and allowing me to move it around really by fingertip control here. Now obviously this is with the lock off. If I want to increase the overall amount of resistance on the mount, I can just add a few tweaks to this just with the tip of my finger, just to bind that a little bit more and slow it down. But it just feels so beautifully smooth when you move it. Panning around with this tripod is absolutely great. Another thing about the tripod, it might not be obvious in the pictures here, they haven't gone for a ridiculously wide angle on the legs spreading. So we end up with a relatively modest circle for getting around the binocular. There's the minimum risk I'm going to be tripping over the legs in the dark. It's a small point, but when you're using this thing in the dark, you really don't want legs that are going out over here somewhere that you've almost got to climb over just to move the optical aid round to view a different part of the sky. So I really can't recommend the VT990 any higher than to show it with a product like this in position. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, this is not an economy product. This can only be regarded as an economy product if you compare it to other top-end performing tripods. But to be honest, I'm not sure that in our researches, and I've looked at big tripods a lot for this type of product, I've not really come across anything quite as competent as this tripod relative to the tripod's own weight. You know, it's that really quite extraordinary juxtaposition of the fact that the tripod weighs under 6 kilos and yet it's got a carrying capacity of 20 kilos. That really is an extraordinary feat of portable engineering to be able to achieve that and get it to feel as good as it does. This really does feel like this tripod could probably carry two of these things on here. It really just feels absolutely rock solid on here. I can't recommend it highly enough. In this video, we've given you a very brief overview of the range of tripods in the Fotomate range. You will possibly have to investigate them a little bit further in a dealer near you. There are a couple of other models that we haven't shown you. We started with the 506. I think there's actually at least one model underneath that. And we've gone all the way up here to the VT990, the star of the show. Anyway, we look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye for now.